This one is interesting. Perplexity, they just launched a new search API a few hours ago. And with this update, Perplexity has moved away from answers and it gives you more control. And there are four amazing things it can do for you. The first one is pure retrieval, which is you get raw snippets and sources. So it's good for, say, RAG or research workflows. Second one is grounded chat, where it gives you quick summaries with sources like the old node, but with faster and more flexible responses. Third one is filtered sources, where you get results from specific URLs and timeframes. And fourth, which I love the most, is structured outputs. So instead of getting simple responses in strings, you get outputs in arrays and the format that you define. So I've tested all four of these in my workflow, and I also compared them with the old node that we used to have, the Perplexity node. So let's just go through that one. I can explain whatever issues that I faced and what are the things that it can or cannot do. So as you can see, I created five workflows. The first one is using the old Perplexity API, the node that we used to get in N8N. And then the new API one, which is finding results. Second one is grounded search. Third one is filtered sources. And the fourth one is structured outputs. So we'll just walk through all four of them. How do you connect the new API? And then how do you use that? So for the first one, it used to be super simple that you just add the Perplexity node here. I'll just unpin this one. And what happens is that it, based on the chat input, you get the responses. It will search the internet, search Google for you, and you will get a response. You can add a lot of things like the number of tokens it can use, the frequency penalty and everything, and also the model, that which model that you want to talk to. So what used to happen with this one is that, for example, if I do a quick query, which is summarize today's biggest AI and digital marketing announcements for a LinkedIn update, let's just send it and see what it comes up with. And you can see it came up with a long response on what exactly happened, expanded AI ecosystem and all those things. No citations, nothing. And yeah, it's very, very answer driven. You are not getting the raw output here. So this is how the old node used to work. And talking about the four new updates, let's just go through the first one. So I'll just remove the chat trigger from here and move it to this one, because we can only have one chat trigger per workflow. So I have a agent, AI agent tool here, model. I will not take you through all of those things, but more about how do we connect Perplexity API here. So once you do that, you just call the HTTPS node here, and within the HTTPS node, you have to fill in a few things. So what you have to do is that you have to go to Perplexity's API docs, and there they have the search API and the documentation here, the four options here, which is your find results, retrieval, chat with grounded search, filter your sources, and a structured output. So what you can do is just quickly go to curl request from here, copy this one as it is, this URL here, and you go back and click on import curl, just like that, as it is. And what happens is that after that, it will fill everything here. The only thing that you have to change it, when you fill it, this bearer token will not be there. So after bearer, what you have to do is you have to go back to your Perplexity account, create a new key, name it whatever you want. For example, here I created a search API test. Copy this key from here by pressing copy and paste it right next to bearer, and done. It will be here, and this is the key that you can use, it will use for this particular request. So the thing that you have to keep in mind is that there is one more option, which is authentication using predefined credentials type, right? So predefined credential type, which is the existing API credentials that you have linked here. But the thing is, this will not work. I tried and I failed, and I was not sure what exactly is happening. So do not try this predefined credential type. You just have to go with none and send headers, which is your bearer, because the existing credentials doesn't work. At least for me, it didn't work out. So you will need to use this bearer value here. So once it's done like that, let me just tell you what else to change. So I'm going to just paste it here for now. Go back to this curl, copy it, import curl, import. So once you import from here, you see the bearer, your API key, it's gone. So go back to Perplexity, copy your API, and here you just replace this one with the API key that you just received. And in the body, so this is the format that you have to follow. So what is comment browser, perplexity? So you have to change it so that it can become dynamic. It can respond to your incoming chat. So what you have to do, I will just use whatever I was using. So just have to keep the query, which is your JSON.chat input, which is coming from this previous node on the left. All right. So once you do that, I think it should be good to go. So let's go back and try it out. So now I have a chat message. Let me just quickly ask it something which is relevant to find results. What are the recent changes in HubSpot pricing, new features and competitor responses last 60 days? So this is my message to this second API, which is your find results. Let me just send it. And now it's working and we have an output. Let's see. Okay, so there are no recent detailed search results specifically about the changes in HubSpot pricing, new features, and so HubSpot did not come up with any new pricing. So yeah, but this is how it works when it comes to fetching the results. So this is how it works when it comes to fetching the results using the new API. So that was the second one. And now if we move on to the third one, which is grounded search. What happens is that, let me just bring it here, click here. And you see it's the same HTTPS node, nothing has changed. The only thing that will change here is the body, JSON body. So the bearer remains the same. You'll have to just copy paste it again. So you go back to the API docs, go start with chat with grounded search, copy this curl, add it by clicking this import curl here as it is. Then you'll have to replace or insert the key again. And after that, this body, you will need to change it, tweak it to something like this, which is based on JSON.chat input. Because what will happen is it is going to give you this role, users, content, what are the major AI developments and announcements and blah, 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 blah. So I just removed it and changed it to content equal to JSON.chat input because I need everything that is coming in from the chat input and a response to that. So for this one, let's just try it again and see how it will work. So, okay, sorry. Let's just open the chat again. And what are the most important updates in Google Ads and Meta Ads this week that marketers should know? Let's just ask it that thing. And let's see what happens, whatever it comes up with. Yep, so these are the most important updates for marketers this week. New features unify advertising across web and app platforms, performance max, AI powered ad quality prediction, and updated policies enforced from October 28, 2025, and so on with Meta. So this is how it works for grounded search. And now the third and fourth one are the interesting ones because you need to give it multiple sources. So the third one is the filter sources. What happens here is that in filter your sources, the curl has a few additional things. Number one is content, which is the query, whatever you are asking, but also you can limit it by the domain, that what, which exact domain you wanted to look into, and also how recent the result should be. So if you use this thing exactly, you follow the same steps again, which is filtered results, this HTTPS node, I just named it filtered results, and you put on your curl request. And after that, in this JSON, but the body that you are sending in, you just change it to these three, whatever there is, you'll have to remove it so that it matches your input. So for example, I'm sending the query, I'm sending the domain name, and I'm also asking for the recency. And how it can work is that, for example, you have a form submission here. Let me just unpin this one. And if I click on execute workflow, search query, what do you want to search? Product updates published. What are the latest marketing and products updates published on HubSpot.com in the past month? And the domain name is HubSpot.com, and how old the result should be. I say month, and if I submit it, so it's working now. And the thing is that these three inputs that we collected, which is your query, the domain, and the last result, this will go into your HTTPS node. The three of them, which is your JSON search query, JSON domain name, and how old the result should be. The three fields from the init and form submission. And in the output, let's see what it gave us. Table. The latest marketing and product updates published in this. So this is, these are all the updates that we have from HubSpot from the last 1 month. Inbound 2025 and commerce, hub launch, enterprise, professional, all those things. Anyway, so this is how you get information from a specific website and based on the recency, that how old the information should be. So this is how you can do filter sources in the API. And the last one is your structured output. So how it works is, again, it will need multiple inputs. So we are giving it again a form. However, you can give it a chat as well. A chat node will do the same thing, because in this form, I am just giving it one single input. But instead of this, you can give it a chat input as well. So how it works is, so what I'm going to do it, just to keep it simple, I'm going to remove this form and I will bring back the chat node from here. Come back. All right, here you go. Right, and after that we have added the structured output HTTPS node. It's the same perplexity node, but I just call it structured outputs. So here you do the fourth curl, which is structured output, and don't get scared by this whole thing, because in the end you are looking for just the content here. So you copy the whole thing, paste it again into import curl, and then add your API key into the bearer token. And in the JSON, so what happens is that we are going to edit the input field, because the query is coming into this field. Let's just go back and start with chat message. Open chat. Let's ask it, find the three most talked about AI tools for marketers released in last month. Include tool name, purpose, and company behind it. The thing is, the reason I did the form was because it was much more better looking. And I think if you think about it that way, it will be more about that, can you create an app out of that? So sorry, but I'm going back to my form because I already spent some time building it. So let's just execute this one. Okay, execute. So the form that I created was that this app is called Marketing Tools Researcher. So you ask for the top tools that you want for your marketing needs. So what I'm going to ask it is, for example, this find three most talked about AI tools for marketers release. Let's remove AI tools everyone's talking about. Let's talk about most talked about CRM tools for marketers released in the last month. All right, so this is my query. Okay, I submit it. Just close it. And then this whole thing is working here. I'll tell you why I put structured output here. But before that, let's look at the output. So you see, there are three things that it came up with. The tool name, Microsoft Dynamics 365. Tool name, monday.com CRM. And tool name, Maximizer. So these are the three most talked about tools when it comes to CRM. And it's giving you the tool name, the purpose, and the company exactly the way that we asked it to do using this, which is tool name, purpose, and company. And we need this array. This is the requirement. However, to make it foolproof and also to add a fallback, what I did was that in the AI agent node, I also added that I need these three structured output in returned in JSON and a backup to that. So I added another structured output parser so that it makes sure that I'm getting three different sets of JSON. So I gave it a sample, an example, based on what I was asking Perplexity to do as well. And because of this, the tool name, purpose, and company, we are getting exactly those three things. So these are just multiple fallbacks and foolproofing how this should work out. So yeah, I mean, you can just rely on the HTTPS node, which is Perplexity API as well. But if you want to make sure that it is foolproof and nothing fails, that you do get JSON every single time, try adding this structured output parser. I faced this problem earlier that if I don't use structured output parser, it may not deliver the result that I want every single time. So this was just a quick look around how the new search API stacks up against the old API, and if there are any differences, if we actually have some control. I'm liking it. I'm liking at least the structured output and the filter resources, these two nodes. But for the others, yeah, we'll keep trying and see. I would love to have a Perplexity node or the current Perplexity node do these things for me without adding a different API, different HTTP node every single time. But yeah, I think they will roll it out in the future, probably soon. So if you like this video and if you think that it helped you out, please give me a like, subscribe the channel. It helps. Cheers. See you in our next video.